estamos cantando este canto, pude ver que cada vez clamamos Yeshua, veía como un martillo que estaba martillando, golpeando una pared. Cada vez que nosotros declaramos Yeshua, no sé por qué, pero estaba viendo como un martillo clavando una pared. No sé qué significa, hermanos, pero ciertamente si yo vi, si el Espíritu Santo nos reveló que había un martillo pegando una pared, eso significa que el Yeshua está haciendo algo en nuestro favor. Eso significa que Yeshua está clamando hacia nosotros, amén. En este momento, si tú puedes levantarte de ahí donde tú estás, hermano, familia, en este momento vamos a seguir clamando que Yeshua se levanta con nosotros, porque el que está con nosotros es mucho más mayor que ningún demonio, que ninguna enfermedad. Es Yeshua, el Dios con nosotros, el Dios omnipotente, el Dios soberano.
Jesus, hallelujah, church, amen, hallelujah, y miliares, y miliares, y miliares, amen, mi amado es, amen, that it means that my lover is so much more beautiful than millions and millions and millions, amen. You know, I'm so glad to come in this morning on this podcasting radio, amen. You know, sometimes it just takes a little bit. Amen. We got to ponder. We got to linger. You know, God wants to see that, you know, this isn't just a job or this is like a job. No, this is about getting into God's presence. Amen. And you feel like you got to work up to something, you know. And really, it's just where your soul's at. Where's the Holy Spirit at? Amen. Are you getting those endowments, those deposits? And you know, that's continually staying in prayer and staying in the progress of where God has you. That sometimes, you know, you can feel like you're in a rock and a hard place, and it's not as easy as turning the corner. Oh, there you are. You know, just turn on the light. Oh, there you are. You know, you just turn the corner and you're in front of a mirror, and before you know it, oh, there you are. You know, it's not when you want it, okay? It's not a quick second. No, it's in God's timing. See, God can do anything that He wants to do because He's God. That's what allows Him to be God. He's the master. He's the master planner. Come on now. That defines our lives and see the crevices and the crevices and the so many different portals and parts of our lives, that there's some deep things that have to be worked on. Amen. And because there's so many deep things that have to be worked on, you know, these things are superficial. We got to wait on God. We got to count on God. We got to believe in God. Amen. Because He's our source. He's the river. Come on now. That we flow in. He's the river that not only that we flow in, but we swim in. Hey, if you want to go forward, backwards, you know, you got to do what you got to do. But being in the presence of the Lord, it takes time. It takes effort. It takes listening. It takes hearing. You know, that's the reason why the word says, seek the Lord while He may be found. Amen. Because when we seek the Lord, we will find Him. When we knock on the door, see, there's some work that has to be done there, because we're knocking now. We're knocking on the door. And the Lord says that He will open up that door. And you know, when you find that door to be open, it's like you have opened heavens over your life. Because no longer is it about only your situation. Come on now. And sometimes it might be petty. Sometimes it... You know, it may not be petty. It's real. It hurts. There's a soreness there. But God is saying, let me in that area. Because I can't have you messed up from the floor up. Come on now. I can't have you in this brokenness. Let me come in and heal you. Let me come in and soothe that. You know, just smooth that over and feel all the cracks. Just feel all the areas of your heart, you know, where people have misled you, maybe treated you wrong to that song. Come on now. And there's, it's resourceful, but at the same time, it's remorseful. You know, but God doesn't want us to murmur and complain as well, whatever that He's given us as well. To be the blessing. To be the blessing giver. Even when it seems to be so, so very hard. But God knows your heart. He knows where you're standing today. The promises of God are here to create as well riches. Wealth and riches are in our houses in Jesus' mighty name. You know what, church? We always have a good enough for every good work. Always. There's not when I don't have, when I'm trusting and believing in our Lord and in our Savior. Can I hear an amen? You know, that's what took me to Psalms 37. As we're trusting in the Lord today for His word to work within our lives. Amen. And you know, one of the things that has been ringing in my spirit is about those who justify. And, you know, justice is doing a right. See, you can have two wrongs that don't make a right. But the Lord said, where there's a wrong and a right, you can make it to be right. Because there is a right. And then when you have two rights, you know, even on the wrong page, you know, God can still turn that out to be for the right. And so it's until we get in the agreement until we get into the flow, until we get together on certain issues and things. That's what's going to lead us to the promised land. Can I hear an amen? So we have to lead in the spirit of righteousness. And as I was reading today, the Lord was reminding me, the Lord says that He is righteous and justice. He's righteous and justice in His throne. Amen. And I love that when I read that. Amen. Because God is righteous as well as justice. Amen. And that's what the Lord surrounds Himself in. We're gonna be reading several outlooks on this, but there in Psalms 37, I'm just gonna hit certain areas because I do want to hit Psalms 97 as well. So if you got a pencil and paper, you can do that as well. Amen. Psalms 37, the Lord reads, "Do not fret because those who are evil, or be envious of those who do wrong. For like the grass, they will soon wither, and like green plants, they will soon die away." And so we see what happens with those who are evil. But God is another word. A fret is fear. The Lord does not want you to be fretful or fearful for those who are evil, and not be envious of those who are doing something wrong. Can I hear an amen? For like the grass, they will soon wither, and like the green plants, they die away. Why? Because the Lord is saying we need to trust. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in this land and enjoy this safe pasture of this land. Take delight in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. Committing your way to the Lord and trusting in Him, and God will do this. See, there's some things that God wants us to do as a people of God. Taking delight in the Lord, He gives us the desires of our heart. As we commit our way to the Lord and to trust Him, God will do this. What is God going to do? He will give you the desires of your heart and will make your righteous reward shine like the dawn. That your vindication is like the noonday sun. And you're saying, well, how is this supposed to happen? How can I make this happen? Well, God is saying, you got to be still in this. You got to be still. You got to be wait patiently for Him. In other words, we're going to wait patiently. We're going to wait this out. We're going to wait on the Lord as we take delight in the Lord and knowing that He will give us the desires of our heart. As we refrain from all evil, we refrain from all anger, that, you know what, and we turn away from wrath, we turn away from evil, we turn away from fret. Because when we have evil, when we have fret, and we want to do a payback, come on now, we talked about having grace and mercy the other day. And so we see that when we do away with this, we're going to do away with all evil. See, we have to know that we're not walking in an adulterous spirit, a fornication spirit, an evil spirit. No, God wants us to refrain from anger and turn from wrath. And do not fret, because that will only lead to evil. And sometimes it may not be this way, going the other way, right? Ourselves leading to the other person. It might be even the other person doing it to you, and you feel like they're just stomping on your feet. Come on now. But God is saying, do not fret. In other words, don't pay evil for evil. Do not fear for those who do evil, or be even envious of those who do wrong. Because sometimes the wrong may look like a right, and even though it may look like a right, or it sounds like a right, but it still can be in the wrong. Because sometimes we think in our own minds that we're right, when we're not realizing the effect that we have affected unto others. It's just like a sickness. Hey, if you're in quarantine, stay away. If you have anything that's there's an infectious, a disease, maybe a pussing or something that can be gross, you know what? We got to stay clean. And to prevent all those things, we have to stay clean. So how are we going to be without the coughs? How are we going to, because we're coming into a season. We just had we're here in the, you know, the greatest Dallas-Fort Worth metroplex. And we just had a lot of rain, a lot of chill. Right now we got some sun popping out. But I'm telling you, hey, we got to use godly wisdom. Use some Lysol out there. Come on now. You got to spray to kill the germs. We got to wipe down with bleach. And we got to keep things clean. And our person has to be clean as well. And so there's a lot of things that have to happen. There's a lot of things that have to be done so that we can leave clean lives, holy lives, separated lives, to give God the honor, to give God the glory. See, in a little while, the wicked will be no more. And though you look for them, they will not even be found. But listen to what the word says. But the meek will inherit the land and enjoy the peace and prosperity. Even the wicked plot against the righteous, even their gashing of their teeth at them. But the Lord, say with me, they may be doing what they may be doing. You see what I'm saying? They may be plotting against you. Hello. They may be trying to take your peace. They may be trying to take your joy. The enemy is that way, just gashing their teeth, just wanting to be evil towards you. But see, he knows their day is coming. The Lord laughs at the wicked. Come on now. And bend the bow and just bring down the poor and the needy, to slay those whose ways are upright. See, God will always fight for the righteous. God will always fight for the righteous. God will always fight for those who are just. God will fight for always those that are pure. God will fight for you. You know, just like the song that was just on. You know, God's never lost the battle. In the midst of the battle and in the battlefield, God's got your back. And one of the things, you know, the Lord loves the just, and he will not forsake his faithful ones. Are we being faithful in the midst of the storm? Are we being faithful in the midst of the battle? Are we being faithful? Because he's accounted unto us as righteousness. Come on now. If anything, there's nothing wrong. being right. There's nothing wrong in doing right. And one of the things that the Lord is saying, now I'm going to take you to Psalms, there in chapter 97. The Lord reigns. And you know, one of the things that was ringing in my spirit, if the Lord reigns, then let him reign. Let God take the reins. Come on now. You're not the boss. He's made you a steward of, you know, being a boss, of doing these things. And he would judge the people with like equality of equalness. The Lord reigns. The Lord reigns. Let the Lord reign in your life today. The Lord, the word says there in 97 verse 1, let the earth be glad. Let the distant shores, let those things rejoice. That the clouds and the thick darkness, you know, it may surround him, but that doesn't make him less God. Just like that doesn't make you less you. And this is what I opened up. That righteousness and justice are the foundations of his throne. And fire goes before him and consumes his foes on every side. That is, even as lightning, it just lights up the world. And the earth sees it and trembles. And the mountains melt like wax before the Lord, because the Lord of all the earth. Before the Lord of all the earth. It didn't say some of the earth, like saying some of the people. No, this is all of the people and all of the earth. That the heavens proclaim his righteousness, and all peoples will see his glory. See, all who may worship images are put to shame, and those who boast in idols, worship him, all you gods. Because Zion hears and rejoices, and the villages of Judah are glad. Why? Because of your judgments, Lord. For you, O Lord, are the Most High over all the earth. Once again, not half of the earth, not some of the earth, but all of the earth. And you are exalted far above all gods. See, God has your back in all processes. And I know it can be hard sometimes to sing a new song. But there in Psalms 97, I'm going to finish out there in 97, verse number 10. The Lord says that let those who love the Lord hate evil, for he guards the lives of his faithful ones. Once again, are we being faithful to the word, to the promises, to what God has spoken? Because the Lord delivers them from the hand of the wicked. Is not that what we want? See, the light shines on the righteous, and the joy on the upright in heart. That we rejoice in the Lord, that you who are righteous and praise his holy name. Rejoice in the Lord, you who are righteous, and praise his holy name. Let us pray today. Father God, we ask you, Lord, that if we have sinned in any way, shape, or form, Father God, I pray that you will wash me and cleanse me with your precious blood. Set me as righteousness before your throne. Set me, Lord, in faithfulness in your throne of love and joy and peace and mercy and grace. Let these things follow me all the days of my life, that I may live in the land of more than enough, Father. I thank you, Lord, for being a just God. I thank you, Lord, for saving me and keeping me and giving me peace. Peace that surpasses all understanding. Touch the hearts of those who want to give, Lord. Make a way where there seems to be no way, Heavenly Father. Transport us, Lord, in the likeness of thy kingdom. For thy is the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for making a way and making our way prosperous in our coming and our going. Thank you, Lord, that we always have enough for every good work. We thank you, Heavenly Father God, that you've made a way for me and my family and my loved ones. Thank you, Father God, that you've always led us out triumphantly, Father. That you always show yourself to be strong and to be brave and to be bold. That, Lord, there's nothing missing. Lord, there's nothing broken. That you are a continuance within my life as I stand in awe before my Lord, my God, whom is my Savior. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen and amen. Church, if you have said this prayer with me, or maybe even have given your life to the Lord, message me. Message me, because I want to pray with you and for you in this season. I know that you may feel it at a glimpse, maybe in a rock and a hard place, but I want to let you know that God will never leave you nor forsake you, and that he will always lead you into your best, for always the best is the next to come. Give over evil, those who do evil, those who say evil, those who are around you that are evil. Father God, we just give them to you today. We release them into your hands. Free us, Father, from any chains of darkness. Break bondages and heavy yokes, and set your captives to be free today. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Church, I love you. God bless you. Know that God is answering prayer for you and with you. And you know, don't fret. Don't fret. Trust in the Lord. Take delight in the Lord. Commit your way unto the Lord. Trust in him that God rewards those who are righteous, even to shine like the dawn. Amen. God bless you, church. We love you. Thank you for traveling with me. Amen. There's Traveling Grace here. And check out Tina Viesca Designs. Amen. We made some new t-shirts for Thanksgiving. Maybe you're having a group meeting. Maybe you're doing an outreach. And hey, we got I put a 30% discount out there. Amen. And so take advantage of that. Know that as we are giving into these different aspects of ministry, that it is helping feeding our third world countries that is needed so much in Nigeria, in as well as in Pakistan. We love you, church. God bless you. And until next time, amen and amen. God bless you, church. Amen.
Stone, taking over.